Welcome to the Philippines' premier motor show. This is Auto Focus. I'm Ray Louis Gamboa. Here are our features on this edition of your electronic magazine, exclusive to the automobile and its industry.
Starting off, interviews of two vehicle models presently in the local market, a compact sport sedan from BMW, the 318i Sport, and a midsize SUV from Subaru, the Outback 2.5i T-iSight. Let's say feature-to-feature comparison of two midsize SUVs, the Isuzu MU-X LSE versus the Nissan Terra VL. On Autopedia, we'll talk about checking an engine light, and together with the latest news and developments in the local auto industry, we shall have the relaunch of the Kia brand as our special feature.
The next 60 minutes is all about the automobile. This is Auto Focus, and we'll be right back after this short break.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Be part of the 2021-2022 Auto Focus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Auto Focus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Auto Focus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
The Mitsubishi Strata Athlete, confident to the core.
Welcome back to Auto Focus, the automobile show. We start this edition of your electronic magazine with a review of one of the latest automobile models from BMW. Looking for an entry-level compact sports sedan for just around 3 million pesos? Then let's check out the BMW 318 iSport.
There are entry-level sedans and there are entry-level compact sedans. Some are priced at around a million. Some are priced at thrice that price. So if you're in the upper bracket of entry-level compact sedans, perhaps the BMW 318i Sport is for you. It's 4,709mm long, 1,827mm wide, and 1,435mm tall. Those dimensions just within compact sedan size allow BMW to roll out a sedan that is sleek, squat, and looks race-ready. The latest 3 Series features another striking iteration of the signature BMW kidney grille and a distinctive headlamp design. The 318i Sport exterior features BMW's individual high-gloss shadow line and sport line packages, LED headlights with extended contents like rain sensors and automatic driving controls, LED fog lights and 18-inch bicolor light alloy wheels with V-spoke styling and yes, run flat tires. Exterior features that make this 3 Series variant that much more convenient to drive are front and rear park distance control and rear view camera. The 318i Sport also features automatic tailgate operation for loading the 480-liter trunk which comes with BMW's storage compartment package. The 318i Sport interior speaks of both luxury and performance. There's ambient light automatic 3-zone air conditioning, interior trim finishes, velour floor mats, Sensatec upholstery for the seats. The driver and front seat passenger get sport seats that hug one comfortably on long drives or when pushing the vehicle at pace on switchbacks. The front seats can be adjusted electronically with memory function for driver. Beamers are a driver's car. One can tell from the dash and instrumentation. Everything is angled toward the driver. Controls are all within easy reach. The BMW's live cockpit comes with round analog dials for speedometer and tachometer, and a 5.1-inch display as well as the 8.8-inch touch display. The 318i Sport also features BMW's iDrive system, which makes controlling secondary vehicle systems as well as the infotainment so much easier via a single control knob on the center console. Adding the convenience of driving the BMW 3 Series or multifunction controls on the steering wheel. Underneath the hood of the 318i Sport is BMW's twin-power inline 4-cylinder gasoline engine with 1,998 displacement. The engine generates 156 horsepower from 4,500 to 6,500 revolutions per minute and 250 Nm of torque from 1,300 to 4,300 RPM. The engine drives the rear wheels via an 8-speed automatic transmission system with Steptronic function. One starts and stops the engine with a push of a button. The 318i Sport brought to local shores comes with automatic start-stop function that automatically shuts and starts engine to minimize the time spent on idle, like when waiting for the light to turn green at intersections. The BMW suspension system, featuring McPherson struts in front and multi-link system in the rear, is tuned to provide a smooth ride on well-paved surfaces and great handling at speed and on switchbacks. The BMW braking system provides great confidence and control in all driving conditions. It also comes with brake energy regeneration that charges the battery while braking. The servotronic system makes steering quite effortless at slow speeds, while reducing steering assist to provide greater control at higher speeds. BMW's driver experience control system also allows the driver to adjust the driving dynamics of the 318i Sport. Cruise control with braking function also makes long drives in extra space all the more relaxing. Other cool features include the interior and exterior mirror package that automatically dims reflection so driver is not dazzled or blinded, especially by high beam headlights of other cars at night. Finally, adding to the convenience of driving the BMW 318i Sport is the parking assistant that lets the car park itself. The BMW 318i Sport made available locally comes with a slew of active and passive safety systems. These include airbags for driver and front passenger, front and rear head airbags, side airbag for driver and front passenger, side impact protection, and ISOFIX child seat mounting. Other safety features include anti-lock braking system, dynamic stability control, dynamic traction control, electronic vehicle immobilizer, automatic locking, and crash sensor.
The BMW 318i Sport is certainly worth checking out if one is looking for a truly luxury compact sport sedan. The latest auto industry news and developments right after this break.
Suzuki Eltiga. Seven-seater in style.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Welcome back to AutoFocus. We now have the latest auto industry news.
Mazda prides itself in rolling out stylish premium SUVs and sedans. This now extends to the pickup it added to the local Mazda lineup, the all-new BT50. Mazda Philippines says the all-new BT50 has been rebuilt from ground up to add premium car-like comfort, elegance, and style to the strength, stance, and functionality of its dedicated workhorse. The new BT50 brings power and stature and prestige into the pickup market as it sits proudly among the rest of Mazda's Scott Soul of Motion-inspired lineup, according to Mazda Philippines President and CEO Stephen Tan. Customers will find in the new BT50 the same premium quality, comfort, durability, and driving satisfaction that they have come to expect from every Mazda, Tan added. Mazda is offering the Mazda BT50 in three variants, including a 4x4 automatic, all powered by a 3-liter inline intercooled equipped variable geometry turbo diesel engine that generates 190 horsepower and 450 Nm of torque. It is also equipped with the latest safety, driver assist, and smart connectivity features found in Mazda's flagship models, including MEST, the Mazda Active Safety Technology. As with every other brand new Mazda model, the all-new BT50 comes with a 5-year free service plan offering the expenses of periodic maintenance at either 6-month or 10,000-kilometer intervals for up to 5 years or 100,000 kilometers. The holidays may also be the season for new slogans. Mitsubishi Motors Philippines Corporation, MMPC, has just come out with a new local slogan, Life Made Better. In explaining the new slogan, MMPC President and CEO Takeshi Hara says it reflects the carmaker's revitalized commitment to significantly contribute to enriching the car life experience for Filipinos. The Life Made Better slogan also expresses MMPC's aim to significantly contribute to the recovery and growth of the Philippine economy. The company is well placed to attain that goal as it is one of the remaining car brands still assembling vehicles in the country. The MMPC factory in Santa Rosa, Laguna produces the Mitsubishi Mirage, the Mirage G4, and the L300, generating thousands of jobs as well as business opportunities for local suppliers. MMPC also plans to add more of its network of dealerships, now numbering 59 nationwide. Auto Cars Philippines has brought in the 11th generation Civic just in time for the traditional holiday rush for vehicle sales. Honda Civic fans will love that all three variants offered locally are powered by the same 1.5-liter 4-cylinder DOHC VTEC turbo engine that generates 178 PS and 240 Nm of torque, all mated to a continuously variable transmission. Honda loyalists should also be excited by the inclusion of a variant already in RS trim. The top-of-the-line RS Turbo CVT Honda Sensing features black-painted side mirrors, door handles, shark fin antenna, trunk spoiler, chrome-finished dual exhaust pipes, and matte black wheels, as well as the 10.2-inch full digital instrument cluster and suede leather upholstery. The RS, S, and V variants come with Honda Sensing, a suite of driver assist technologies as well as other advanced passive and active safety features that include speed-sensing door locks and multi-view reverse camera. The all-new Civic is longer than its predecessor, comes with a lengthier wheelbase and hood, and according to Honda, has been designed to look more mature with both elegance and sportiness in mind. Standard features include keyless entry system and automatic climate control, as well as touchscreen display audio systems with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay capability, with the RS getting the larger screen along with wireless Apple CarPlay. The infotainment system powers 4 speakers in the S, 8 speakers in the V, and 12-speaker Bose sound system in the RS. Prices are 1.29 million pesos for the S Turbo CVT, 1.498 million for the V Turbo CVT, and 1.69 million for the RS Turbo CVT.
Those are the latest news and developments in the automotive industry. We shall take another short break. Stay with us. I'll be right back.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
Extra
with the Mitsubishi Xpander Cross.
Be part of the 2021-2022 AutoFocus People's Choice Awards. the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. We'll win. You choose, you decide. Vote now.
The all-new Nissan Almera takes on every challenge with you. Equipped with what you need, premium and dynamic design that's an absolute stunner. Innovative tech for a drive that's safe and confident. And an efficient turbocharged engine to take you where you want to go. The all-new Nissan Almera challenged the standards.
Every time I'm on the road, I can expect high performance from Phoenix Fuels. Now with Pulse technology, delivers enhanced power and acceleration to make every trip come alive.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine. Here's our feature-to-feature comparison of the latest automobile models belonging to the same category on Head-to-Head. In this Head-to-Head, we pit the Isuzu MU-X LSE 4x4 automatic against the Nissan Terra VL 4x4 automatic in a spec-to-spec comparo of Japan brand 7-seater mid-size SUV.
The Isuzu MU-X has at one time or another been one of the most popular SUVs in the local market. The Nissan Terra is among the newer entries in the market seeking to be counted among the major players in the segment. The all-new Isuzu MU-X LSE 4x4 automatic is 4,850mm long, 1,870mm wide, and 1,825mm tall, with a 235mm ground clearance and 2,855mm long wheelbase. It arrived with an exterior that featured thick lube grille and tungsten silver and chrome, auto-leveling Aero signature bi-LED headlamps framed by daylight running lights and front LED fog lamps, a rear spoiler, winglet signature rear combination lights, LED fog lamp, and high mount stop lamp. The MU-X LSE 4x4 automatic also arrived with body-colored door handles, body-colored side view mirrors with integrated side turn lamp and power adjust and fold function, roof rails with 100kg load capacity, side step board and power tailgate, rain sensing wipers, and 20-inch aluminum alloy wheels with machine cut finish wrap by 265/50R20 tires. The Nissan Terra VL 4x4 AT is 4,900mm long, 1,865mm wide, and 1,865mm tall, with a minimum ground clearance of 225mm and 2,850mm long wheelbase. The Terra arrived with a more aggressive exterior featuring a large V-Motion chrome grille, new bumper design, quad LED projector headlamps, C-shaped daytime running lights, LED front fog lamps, tweaked tail lamps and rear bumper, wide LED signatures plus chrome setter finisher, rear spoiler and shark fin antenna. The body-colored side view mirror with integrated turn signals power adjusts and folds automatically. The chrome door handle comes with an intelligent key switch. The Terra VL 4x4 automatic also features silver roof rails and sidestep, 18-inch two-tone alloy wheels, mudguards, two-speed front windshield wipers with rain sensing function, and single-speed intermittent rear wipers. The MU-X LSE 4x4 automatic comes with remote car lock and engine start system, along with push-start-stop engine function, power tailgate. The interior features leather upholstery for seats and trim. The driver's seat power adjusts 8 ways, the front passenger seat manually adjusts 4 ways. The second row seats for 3 splits and folds 60-40 and come with fold-down center armrest and 3 adjustable headrests. Third row seat for 2 splits and folds 50-50 and also comes with adjustable headrests. The second row seat folds to make room for more luggage and other cargo. The steering wheel tilts and telescopes and features controls for audio, phone, and voice control. Electroluminescent type meters plus a 4.2-inch multi-information display highlight the modern MU-X dash. The MU-X also comes with power door locks and windows, dual-zone climate control system with pollen filter and vents for rear passengers, 12-volt and 220-volt accessory outlets, and USB charging port. The infotainment system features a 10-inch touchscreen display unit with Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, Bluetooth connectivity, auxiliary in, USB port, navigation, and an 8-speaker system. Nissan equipped the new Terra with intelligent key system, push-button engine start-stop, and dual-zone automatic climate control with rear cooler. The VL4x4 automatic variant cabin features black leather for seats and burgundy red leather for the trim and center console padding. The driver's seat power adjusts 10 ways. The front passenger seat manually adjusts 4 ways. The second row seat slides and reclines and comes with center armrest. The third row seat for two splits, folds and tumbles 50-50. The leather-wrapped tiltable D-shaped steering wheel features controls for the audio, hands-free phone, drive assist display, and cruise control. The Terra also comes with a 7-inch advanced drive assist display for the instrument cluster and electronic parking brake switch. The infotainment system features a Nissan 9-inch advanced touchscreen display audio with wireless Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, Bluetooth, USB Types A and C, tuner, iPod navigation, and 8 Bose speakers. It also comes with an 11-inch flip-down monitor with HDMI input. Other interior features include an overhead console with map lights and sunglass holder, 12-volt sockets, wireless charger, Types A and C, USB ports, and bottle and beverage holders. Underneath the hood of the MU-X LS E4x4 automatic is Isuzu's 4JJ3 TCX 2,999cc diesel engine, electronic VGS turbocharger, intercooler, and common rail direct injection that generates 190 PS and 450 Nm of torque. The engine is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission with sequential shift. The top-of-the-line MU-X comes with a 4-wheel drive drivetrain with shift-on-the-fly function, terrain command select dial, and rough terrain mode switch. The all-new MU-X suspension features double wishbones with coil spring, high-mounted upper control arm, and stabilizer in front and 5-link suspension with coil spring and stabilizer bar in the rear. The brake system uses ventilated disc on all 4 wheels. The new Terra still has the 2,488cc inline 4 diesel engine with DOHC and variable turbocharger and intercooler that generates 190 PS at 3,600 revolutions per minute and 450 Nm of torque at 2,000 RPM mated to a 7-speed automatic transmission with manual mode. The VL4x4 automatic features a part-time 4-wheel drive system that can be shifted from 2-high, 4-high, and 4-low and comes with electronic locking rear differential. The Terra suspension system uses independent double wishbones with coil spring and stabilizer in front and multi-link system with coil spring and stabilizer bar in the rear. The brake system uses discs on all 4 wheels, ventilated in front and solid in the rear. The all-new MU-X is fitted with Isuzu's Advanced Driver Assist System or ADAS that features forward collision warning, autonomous emergency brake, turn assist, pedal miss application mitigation, adaptive cruise control, manual speed limiter, automatic high beam headlights, lane departure warning, blind spot monitoring, and rear cross traffic alert. It also comes with a reverse camera with what Isuzu calls rear 4-eye parking aid. Other safety features include 7 airbags, anti-lock brake system, electronic brake force distribution, brake assist, brake override system, electronic stability control, traction control system, hill start assist, hill descent control, 7 ELR seat belts, child seat tethers, side door impact beams, engine immobilizer, child-proof rear door locks, rear defogger. The new Terra comes with enhanced Nissan Intelligent Mobility Tech features that include intelligent forward collision warning, intelligent emergency braking, rear cross traffic alert, lane departure warning, blind spot warning, and intelligent rear view mirror. The VL4x4 variant is also equipped with intelligent around view monitor with moving object detection and off-road monitor as well as intelligent driver alertness. Also added for safety are multiple airbags, 3-point ELR seatbelts, anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, brake assist, vehicle dynamic control with 4-wheel active brake limited slip, parking sensors, high mount stop lamp, anti-theft system with alarm and engine immobilizer.
Both Isuzu and Nissan have gone all out to outfit and fill their 7-seater mid-size SUV entries with cutting-edge exterior and interior features that should make them among the top-of-mind options in the segment.
Na, 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 na. Wes. Take the lead.
Be it fine dining, a romantic garden wedding, a relaxed casual meal, or an important business event, Ilustrado is the place to go. Aside from its famed paella, the Ilustrado restaurant, which is located within the history-laden walled city of Intramuros, is also the favorite destination of food gourmands for its famous callos and lengua and other classic gustatory offerings. Ilustrado Restaurant, only for the foodies.
Be part of the 2021-2022 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Autofocus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
The all-new Nissan Almera takes on every challenge with you. Equipped with what you need, premium and dynamic design that's an absolute stunner. Innovative tech for a drive that's safe and confident. And an efficient turbocharged engine to take you where you want to go. The all-new Nissan Almera challenged the standards.
Motul is the most trusted motor oil of the top teams competing in some of the world's most grueling race competitions, the WRC, the WTCC, and the Japan GT. Motul is the only 100% fully synthetic motor oil in the market. It has antioxidation properties that prevent premature thickening and aging due to thermal stress and guarantees total engine protection. For more information about Motul engine oils, visit www.motul.com.ph.
Welcome back to Autofocus, the country's premier automobile news and features electronic magazine. Our special feature is next. Kia Philippines has just relaunched its brand in the Philippines and celebrated it with a preview of 2 new models, the all-new Sorento and the Stonic Style Edition. In the following special feature, we find out more from Kia Philippines President Manny Aligada about the reasons for the brand relaunch, what it encompasses, why social entrepreneur and innovator Ilac Diaz is heavily featured in it, and 2 new models mentioned.
Kia Philippines has just relaunched a brand locally. The event streamlined on its official Facebook page and YouTube channel. The event was impressive and drew heavy social media traffic with a dramatic presentation of the new Kia logo, an explanation of the new global slogan, Movement That Inspires, and the unveiling of 2 new available models, the 4th generation Sorento and the new Stonic Style Edition. In the Stream Kia brand relaunch, Kia Philippines President Manny Aligada said the brand's newly enhanced brand purpose is to create spaces that will inspire consumers through its product design, create more time for consumers so they can focus on what inspires them and what they aspire for, and innovative experiences that can influence people in today's culture. During a private conference with Sunshine Television, Manny further explained the objective of brand relaunch, which is aligned with Global Kia's rollout of the new logo, slogan, and philosophy.
The intention of the rebrand goes beyond the change in the logo. It's easy to change visuals, but it goes beyond that. The intention is to send out the message that Kia is out there to be a very significant and relevant player in the automotive industry. The objective is very straightforward, though. It's to present the intentions of the brand, to be appreciated by the target markets, be able to communicate that we are going to continue to develop vehicles that are meaningful, relevant, useful, and then within easy reach of the buying public. And it encompasses all buying prospects. No? And this is the reason why we are also communicating the direction of developing new technologies spearheaded by our Kia headquarters.
The brand relaunch also heavily featured social entrepreneur and innovator Ilyak Diaz of the Leader of Light fame, who spoke of his many programs and advocacies all aimed at uplifting underserved and underprivileged communities. Manny explains how Diaz was chosen to represent the kind of brand transformation that Kia has undertaken.
We had options in choosing the party that could represent our intentions. People who are aligned with our objectives, people who are aligned with what we want to happen. And there are many of them, but Ilyak Diaz was one who stood out because for a long time, ever since he went to graduate school, he had been working on meaningful and relevant programs, not for business, but for relevance to the target party. So he was not working for himself. He was working for communities. We thought that was so consistent with our own objectives to be relevant, simple, but significant. And of course, we had wanted to communicate the message of inspiration. Every time we looked at the project of Ilya, each one was really inspiring to the point that we wanted to ask, what's coming soon? What else is next? And we thought that was very aligned, consistent, and compatible with the new Kia brand.
One of the main talking points during the brand relaunch was providing a whole new customer experience. With this in mind, what can current and would-be Kia vehicle owners expect from Kia Philippines and its network of dealerships?
In our country, still, dealerships play a critical role when you want engagement with a brand. If you want to see the product, if you want to buy the product, if you want to test the product, you have to have that contact. So all of these are worked on and prepared for so that the prospect or the customer feels safe, secure, and well-informed. All the way to the time you purchase, that experience must be impeccable. When you engage with us, we make sure that there is proper response. When you look at our websites and you make yourself known, there are elements within our systems that respond to you properly. If you visit our dealerships, our frontliners across the nation are all trained, whether you are there for an inquiry, an actual purchase, or for service. Service is a repetitive experience. Regardless of your choice of dealership, that must be predictably Kia quality.
Kia Philippines took the opportunity to introduce two new models at the same time as the Kia brand relaunch. What is the significance of introducing the two new models during the event?
We will be presenting a lot of new developments, no? The Sorento and the Stonic Style Edition being the first because we launched now. And the Sorento is now available. It is the all-new Sorento, sporting a new face and with much better technology inside. And we thought it best to use it because it embodies the dynamism of the new brand image. So the Sorento with its latest technologies make for a good introduction of the brand. The Stonic Style Edition, on the other hand, is our contribution to the younger set. Stonic being our bestseller in this past year. We thought it best to come up with a new variant in the Style Edition because we wanted others to experience as well the products that we make available. But we're not stopping there. There will be others that are coming very soon.
Will electric vehicles be among the new models coming soon?
For the Philippines, we have to work on the environment and the ecosystem that is needed to make sure ownership of an electric vehicle is viable. So one is purchase, second is ownership. For the electric vehicle to work here in the country, in any part, in fact, you have to make sure that support systems are there. Charging stations, locations of the charging stations, and other elements that may be needed support systems for maintenance of the electric vehicle is another thing. So all of these have to be worked on to make sure that ownership is viable. And therefore, that has to be done concurrently with the development of the product. And we have models abroad. We're just trying to work locally so that all of those points will be addressed when we are ready to launch.
Kia Philippines believes the new brand message, movement that inspires, comes at a time when Filipinos all could use a reminder that there's still a future to be optimistic about and that dreams can still be achieved with just the right inspiration.
As always, we offer the best that Kia has to offer. We made known our intentions through this brand relaunch, and we are targeting to provide excellent customer experiences from the time you get information from us to the time you engage any of our associates, all the way to constant visits through the after sales experiences. So come and visit our website and our dealers, because they are all safe for visits. And as we open the new economy with new hope, this move of Kia to inspire everyone is so timely.
Kia should be hoping that the brand relaunch and the introduction of two models already carrying the new logo will inspire more people to buy Kia in the figurative and literal sense.
Be part of the 2021-2022 Autofocus People's Choice Awards, the only nationwide poll to determine the country's most popular car brands and models. It's easy. Log on to bit.ly/AFPCA2021, then vote for as many as 5 different models that you believe should become the 2021-2022 Autofocus Automobile of the Year in separate, standard, and premium luxury categories. Vote every day until November 30, 2021. The Auto Focus People's Choice Awards. Who will win? You choose, you decide. Vote now.
I think my dad is secretly a superhero. He's the coolest, smartest, strongest person alive. No matter where we go, he always makes sure I feel safe. And he isn't afraid of anything. My dad likes to call that the power to lead. I call it his superpower.
The Mitsubishi Strata Athlete, confident to the core.
Welcome back. We have more cars for you to know and appreciate as we have our second car review this week. This edition of Car Review takes a look at the venerable Subaru Outback, which can be considered a pioneering crossover.
Many see the Subaru Outback as a station wagon lifted and outfitted to make it better able to take on rougher roads while maintaining all the comforts and conveniences as well as ride and handling of the old-school genre. The 2021 Subaru Outback 2.5 IT EyeSight certainly bolsters this perception with its exterior dimensions and proportions that are more car-like than SUV-like. It is 4,870mm long, 1,875mm wide, and just 1,675mm tall, even with a 213mm minimum ground clearance. A 2,745mm long wheel adds to this perception. Choice bits of cladding aim to give the Outback a sportier edge along with other accoutrements of crossovers and SUVs like the beefy and business-like roof rails with built-in crossbar and rear spoilers. There's nothing boxy about the Outback exterior, which looks streamlined for the most part, with swept-back LED headlamps that come with auto levelizer, as well as a steering response function, an LED daytime running light, plus headlamp washers. The front and rear fog lamps are also LEDs, as well as the turn signals on the power folding door mirrors. The Subaru Outback offered in the country also features a power sliding glass sunroof that can be tilted open. The tailgate opens to more than adequate space for luggage and other cargo at 522 liters. There's also a retractable cover. It's the rainy season, so the automatic rain-sensing windshield wipers should be particularly useful. The Subaru Outback 2.5 IT comes with keyless access and push-button start system. This easily gets you inside the roomy and refined cabin with Nappa leather upholstery and trim. If more than one in the family gets to drive the Subaru Outback, it's possible to get the driver's seat to remember the preferred driving position of each member. This uses Subaru's Driving Monitoring System, or DMS, which uses a dedicated camera to recognize up to 5 drivers and recalls their pre-registered settings. The driver's seat will then automatically and electronically adjust to each driver's settings. So will the side view mirrors, the driver's last viewed screen on the meter display, and the setting on the dual zone auto air conditioning system. The front passenger seat is also power adjustable, but only 8 ways. It's quite comfortable in the back, with good head and leg room, better than the old Outback. The rear seat reclines and splits and folds 60-40 to make room for more cargo or luggage if needed. A center armrest provides even more convenience when not more than 3 occupy the back. The dashboard is highlighted by the 11.6-inch high-definition touchscreen display for infotainment and connectivity that comes with navigation, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, Bluetooth, and voice recognition system. The steering wheel tilts and telescopes and comes with controls for such things as the audio and cruise control. Other nice touches include aluminum pedals, a surfeit of USB and auxiliary audio input portals, electronic parking brake, heated door mirrors, and rear ventilation. Audiophiles will love that the Outback 2.5 IT iSight comes with an 11-speaker Harman Kardon audio system with subwoofer and amplifier. Subaru vehicles have a reputation for having great handling and performance, owing largely to the Boxer engine and symmetrical all-wheel drive system that the company has perfected over the years. This reputation has been bolstered by the development of the Subaru Global Platform, aimed at improving drivability, stability, quietness, and ride comfort. The 2021 Outback fully exhibits the benefits of these technologies. The Outback Subaru brought to the country is powered by a 2,498cc Boxer engine that generates 188 PS at 5,800 RPM and 245 Nm of torque from 3,400 to 4,600 RPM. This is mated to a Lineartronic CVT. Some say a CVT won't provide as much fun one would want driving a Subaru. But the Lineartronic CVT in the Outback provides smooth and stable gear changes that translate to efficient and smooth operation, driving performance and better fuel economy. For those who want some control over gear shifts, the Outback comes with paddle shifters. It also comes with Subaru Intelligent Drive, or SI Drive. A switch on the steering wheel allows the driver to toggle between intelligent and sport mode. The Outback brake system uses ventilated discs on all 4 wheels. The suspension system uses front McPherson struts and double wishbones in the rear, and comes with Stabilex ride system dampers to help deliver a quieter ride. As the local Outback variant suggests in its name, it also comes with EyeSight 4.0 driver assist technology that essentially monitors traffic movement around the Subaru, optimizes cruise control, and warns the driver if the car is swaying outside the lane. Other driver assist technologies in the Outback include hill descent control, auto vehicle hold, rear cross traffic alert, lane change assist, rear view camera and reverse sensors, blind spot detection, auto dimming rear view mirror, adaptive driving beam, auto headlamps. Also making it safer driving and riding on board the Outback are the 4-sensor 4-channel anti-lock braking system with electronic brake force distribution, brake assist, brake override, active torque vectoring, emergency stop signal, engine immobilizer, ISOFIX adaptive child seat anchors, safety pedal system, side door reinforcement beams, front side curtain, front passenger seat and knee airbags, and vehicle dynamics control system.
So Subaru says the 2021 Outback offers true driving enjoyment anywhere in comfort and peace of mind. The Outback certainly has what it takes to back up this assertion. Know more about your car and how to take care of it here on Autopedia.
Hi, this is Sydney, and today we're going to talk about the dreaded check engine light. What it is, what it means, and why you should not freak out. So you're driving normally, minding your own business, and then suddenly, bam! The yellow light of death comes out, the dreaded check engine light. You start freaking out, don't know what to do. You start the car, you stop the car, you turn it on, and it's still there. Oh no, it's the end of the world, something's wrong with my car, my engine is busted. Relax, it's none of those things. Quite simply put, a check engine light simply means that one of the various sensors in the engine senses that something is wrong or is reading wrong. Almost all the sensors in the car measure voltage, as in electricity. It reads anywhere from 0 to 5 volts, and if that sensor is calibrated to read, say, only from 1.5 to 4 volts, then for some unknown reason, it becomes 4.1 volts, then the check engine light will come out. That's all it means. One of the sensors reads something wrong. Now, whether it reads something wrong because of a glitch or temporary condition, or because the sensor is failing, that you will have to find out. And no, you cannot find it out by going on Facebook. You cannot find out going on the internet asking, may check engine ako, ano yung problema? You ask 10 different people, you will get 100 different answers. And none of them will be correct. Especially the people say, oh, nagkaroon na ako niyan, ito yung problema niyan. No, they are wrong. Do not believe them. Because there are 999 possibilities why that light comes out. The only way for you to find out what that means is if you either, one, have a scanner like this, or you bring it to the casa or the dealership and you have a bigger scanner like this. So now we'll show you what happens when you actually do bring your car in for scanning. First, we'll take the regular shop grade scanner that we have here. This reads pretty fast. All scanners will actually have this port. It's a trapezoidal port. It's called an OBD port or onboard diagnostic port. Every car has this port and it's always, always located somewhere here. It's standard that all car manufacturers agree to. So this will work for any car. This will tell you what the check engine means. There's always an error code that starts with the letter P followed by three numbers. You can actually type that into Google and then it will pretty much tell you what it means. So for this Honda City, we actually have a check engine and we're gonna plug this in right now. So we have it plugged in. It's actually here on the corner. You turn the engine on, not start. And we wait for it to fire up because it was now gonna talk to the engine ECU and pull out the error code and see what it means. This is what we mean by the error code. It starts with the letter P, followed by three numbers. On our particular scanner, it actually tells you what component is the problem. So this one here is mass or volume airflow circuit low. It might be an intermittent lean condition, it might be an intermittent voltage condition, or it might be that your mass airflow sensor is over 10 years old and it's dead and it's dying. At least it narrows it down to any of the 999 possibilities, because it could either be mass airflow sensor, misfire, crank sensor, ABS, oxygen sensor 1, oxygen sensor 2, fuel tank evaporation sensor. The list goes on and on and on. So without this, you won't be able to say for certainty what is wrong with the engine, or actually what sensor and what component is wrong with the engine without this. The first thing that shops will do is, oh, that's it? Okay, we just hit erase. So we perform the scan test again. As you can see, message says no powertrain trouble codes. There's no more, 9 out of 10 times. This will work and check engine is gone. No, we unplug the scanner and then that's it. You can go on your merry way. But the bigger question is, will that check engine light return? Possibly yes. Like I said, it's caused by one of the sensors not reading correctly. So why it didn't read correctly, we can only speculate. But the two most common reasons are, one, external factors. It just, something just goes wrong. Electronics do that sometimes. Or it might be a symptom of that particular sensor is on its way to being dead. So it reads wrong now, it reads fine. In the future, it might read wrong again. If it gets too severe, And if you do the erase procedure and it does not erase, that means that the sensor is busted and it's time for replacement. Now, what causes check engine lights? Oftentimes, you'll read on the internet and the groups, masama langis mo. No, that doesn't work. Masama yung gasolina mo. Possibly, yes. Because there is such an engine code called cylinder misfire detected. That was caused by bad batch of gas. Whether your 98 octane is not really 98 or may tubig sa gasolina, you don't know. Can it be caused by faulty spark plugs? Yes, it can also. Can it be caused by me not using the car for 3 years? Possible, because that particular sensor could be busted and rusted. Particularly, let's say, crankshaft position sensors, these things have a magnet inside them. And the engine gets hot, and gets cold, gets hot, gets cold. The magnet eventually becomes less magnetic. That will also cause a check engine. So like I said, you cannot find out for certain without one of these things. Now, actually, if you go to Lazada, you just type OBD scanner, you will find a lot for $400, $700, $900. You can actually just buy one of those and it will work on your car just for you to be able to narrow it down. And if you do bring your car to the shop, make sure that once you scan it, you take a picture of this, show it to the shop so they won't be punching in the dark and asking a lot of questions and basically guessing why. That will be a big help. And if the check engine light doesn't go away, and then if there's something wrong, you really need one of these things. Professional level vehicle diagnostic scanner. This you cannot buy in Lazada anymore. There you have it. Why you should not freak out if your car suddenly has a check engine light, it's not the end of the world. So hopefully now you understand a little bit more better on why it happens and how to get rid of it.
That's our feature on Autopedia this week. Taking care of your ride has been made easier. And that's Autofocus this week. We hope you have found this edition of your electronic automobile magazine informative as well as entertaining. Check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts. On behalf of my dad, Butch Gamboa, this has been your host, Ray Louis Gamboa. Please stay safe and healthy.